Hello and welcome to LES Matters TV. On today's episode of LES Matters TV, I'm going to be giving an overview of what is holistic child development. Okay? When we talk about holistic child development is taking a honest approach, okay? In terms of honest approach, it talks about looking at the physical, intellectual, language, emotional, social, and the cultural aspect of the child, okay? Holistic approach, okay? Holistic child development has to do with taking a holistic approach in relation to child development. And what does that mean? It means looking at the physical, intellectual, language, emotional, social, and the cultural aspect of young children, okay? It is really important in relation to supporting young children to meet their needs. You have to look at how you can support them in relation to their holistic child development, okay? One strand should not be left. So that's why we talk about holistic approach, looking at the wholeness of the child in terms of the physical, intellectual, language, emotional, social, and the cultural aspect of the child, okay? So I'm going to break it down. In terms of physical development, it has to do with the fine and gross motor skills. The child using their fingertips, gross at using their whole body movement. Okay, so physical development has to do with the fine and gross motor skills of the child. The ability of the child to be able to use their fine, which is their fingertips, gross to be able to use their body movement, and intellectual or cognitive. The ability of the child being able to use their imaginations, being able to use their brain. Language, the ability of the child being able to use words, being able to communicate. Emotional development, the ability of the child being able to express their feelings, being able to express themselves. Social development has to do with the child, the ability of the child being able to interact with their peers, interact with the adults, interact with things around their environment. And the cultural aspect of the child, which is really very important, is looking at the cultural aspect of the child. Where is the child coming from? The upbringing of the child, you know, the community where the child is coming from. This is really important, okay? So if you're looking for how you're going to support young children, you should be looking at a holistic approach. You should be taking a holistic approach, not just you focusing on the physical aspect of the child or the social aspect of the child. So you have to make sure you support the overall development of the child. In terms of holistic development, is looking at the overall development of the child in terms of the physical, intellectual, language, emotional, social, and the cultural aspect of the child. So it's really important. If you're the parent of young children, or you're the guardian, or you're a teacher of young children, in relation to you supporting young children, you have to look at how you're going to support their overall development. That's what holistic is all about, the overall development of the child. So you should be looking at, in relation to providing young children with activities, how you're going to use the activities to support their overall development. This is really important. Okay, so for example, if you want to look at storytelling, so you should be looking at how storytelling could support the overall development of the child. So in relation to storytelling, in terms of physical development, let the children flip the pages around. When they flip the pages around, they are using their fine motor skills. When they feel the texture of the book, they are using their fine motor skills. And in relation to their imagination, prompt their curiosity, ask them questions. When you're reading the story with them, let them ask you questions as well. In terms of language, let the children use words associated with the story. Okay, so you can ask them, for example, okay, can you guess what's going to happen in the next page? So you're prompting their curiosity, at the same time you're helping them to use words, to use their language. And in terms of emotional development, let the student be able to express themselves in terms of how they are feeling in relation to the story, which is really important. From birth to 6 years, from younger age, you should give children the opportunity to be able to express their feelings. And in terms of social development as well, storytelling could help in terms of you as the adult and the, you know, the children's peers. They are communicating, they are engaging in discussion with you as well. And also in relation to cultural development, it's important that you can look at culture, you know, look at storybooks in relation to culture to be able to teach children about culture. So it's really important. I want you to really focus on the activities that will support the children's overall development. So how do you go about this? So if you have one activity that you want to present with children, look at that, add that activity we'll be able to support children's holistic development in terms of physical, intellectual, language, emotional, social, and the cultural aspects of the child. I don't just want to look at that activity in terms of just promoting one aspect of the child. This is really important. Holistic child development is really important, taking a holistic approach in terms of supporting children's development. Okay, so it's really important. I want you to take note of this. Whatever activities that you want to present with children, you have to ensure it supports and promotes their holistic development, their overall development in terms of physical, intellectual, language, emotional, social, and the cultural aspects of the child. Thank you so much for watching and listening, and until I come your way next time, I still remain LES Matt Stevie. Take care and mind yourselves now. Bye bye.